have given that b1. So can I not say I can do p1 minus p0 plus b1, and from that I can actually find out the return. I'll give you the format in which I want you to do it. Okay, Aksh, see, if you assume it to be plus point, you can't do it that way because already the returns are in percentage. If the return was in rupees, 10 rupee, and then they say 0.5%, what you're saying is right. But here already the return is also in percentage, so you have to just add 0.5% to that. Okay. Now let me come to this question. I'll first write down working note number one. Working note number one will be return. I'll give you the format, you have to fill it up in the format. Okay. So it will be particulars. Bold, okay. So we have the P0. How much is P0 over here? It is 10,000. How much is P1? That turns out to be 9,800. So I can find out how much is P1 minus P0. That turns out to be how much? 200. I am having D1 also over here. How much is D1? 1725. So I can find out what is P1 minus P0 plus D1 divided by P0. Can you please do this in your books now, friends? Type this into the remaining and tell me what is the answer you get. Friends, after you write down these four, that is, you'll be having gold, you have silver, then you have what, bronze, and what is the last thing that you're having? GOI. Once you do this, please find out the total also after that, okay? Whatever answer you get, please put, give the answer in the chat box. Alright, friends. Okay, whatever answer you get, please give me the answer in the chat box, okay? I'm waiting for your answer. Alright, friends, what is the answer you are getting over there? I just put up the answer over here. The overall answer you will get the answer as, if I am not wrong, it will be 16.7% overall. Individually, you will be getting different answers. That also, please chat and let me know. Once you get this answer as 16.7% friends, in this question they are assuming 16.7% is the overall market return. This is the overall assumption that they have kept in the question. Now this assumption should not be right, because they are assuming, so it is assumed that four securities constitute the market. Four securities constitute the market. Did you write down this in your books now, friends? Fine friends, everybody has put up till here in your books now. Can I go to the next part? Okay. So once you finalize that this is going to be the market, down they have given the average return of the portfolio is how much? 15.7%. Okay. So friends, when they give the average return, they have again assumed that the overall CAPM return is turning out to be how much percentage? 15.7%. And these assumptions are actually not right. But since the study method is doing it in this manner, I am also taking the same as the assumption so that you don't get any confusion. Alright? Fine. Once you have written down till here, let me go to the next part. They want you to find out the expected return of each using CAPM. So we have the RF. Do we have the RF over here? We don't have the RF as of now, correct? Okay. So what we will do is that in order to find out the RF, we know the overall market return, we know the overall CAPM return also. So everyone take a fresh page and write down the next working note heading, overall average beta. Okay, that would turn out to be, what are the betas that we have? 0.6 plus 0.8 plus 0.6 plus 0.01 whole divided by 4. So what is the answer that you get over there? So the average beta over here, you are getting the answer as 0.50. Okay, friends, while normally we should do weighted average, but it's elemental than it using simple average. I am just using the same methodology. Normally, we should only calculate. Normally, we should only calculate what? Weighted average beta. Okay, but here study methods are using this methodology. Can you write down this in your books now? And they are giving a note, you can do it using weighted average also, but then your answer might not tally with the answer what I am getting. Okay, you write down till here in your books. Fine friends, I believe you are done with this. Then what they are doing is, next working note, they are determination of RF. Determination of RF. How they do this is, having got 15.7 is assumed to be the CAPM return. So 15.7 is equal to RF plus, what is the overall beta that they are taking over here? 0.5. RF is how much? 16.7 minus RF. Once you solve this equation, can you not find out the RF? will get the RF as 14.7%. Can you write down this in your books now? Friends, I believe everything is comfortable. Just put a chat, yes or something, just for me to confirm that things are going comfortably. Alright friends, have you all got the RF as 14.7%? Can I go to the next part now? Okay, so once you get the RF as 14.7%, then we can find out the next working note heading would be individual CAPM returns. The individual CAPM returns. Okay. So here I'll give a heading called as security. Okay. Now, for example, the first security is what? Bold. Computation. And what is the last one? Result. Alright. So what is the formula that you will use over here for the security gold? It will be 14.7 RF plus beta. What is the beta for the gold? 0.6 into RM minus RF. I believe the RM we are assuming to be 16.7, right? Into 16.7 minus 14.7. So it will be 2 into 0.6 plus 14.7, that turns out to be 15.90. Like this, you have to do the remaining and finish it off. Can you write down this in your books, friends? So it's 15.9, the second one would be 16.3%, third one is going to be 15.90%, and the last one is going to be 14.72%. Can you complete, finish off writing all this in your books? Okay. I'll give you a minute more, then I'll go to the next question. All right, that's, I believe you are done with this part. Can I go to the next one?